Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Glazebrook. We are at the moment close to field 59. We started a contract harvesting sugar beets on that field. We borrowed the equipment. I'm still driving on the wrong side of the road on this map. It doesn't matter, it's not that much traffic on this road anyway. So we have borrowed the equipment, like I said. Let me show you guys real quick. Field 59 harvesting sugar beet. It's gonna pay us a decent amount of money, especially for this map. Of course, it's gonna take forever until we're gonna finish that field. And we're not gonna do this job because I don't want to get stuck with two jars that will take forever to finish. And let's just stop this tractor, jump into our own fence. We're gonna head on over the fields that we cleared. We're gonna start with 33, then move over to 18, 14 and 13. We're gonna work on those fields. We'll have a course play worker on cultivating field 33, so we can move over right on that field 8, and start planting. I did place a shed. We're gonna pass by and I'm gonna show you guys the shed. It's just a normal shed, nothing fancy. This one right here, so we'll have a lot more space for us to place our equipment from now on. We do need to place another buy point so we can have a place, the fund where we can buy our fertilizer, our seeds, lime, whatever else we need. But for now, let me find the entrance. It's right here. I'm gonna follow this road and it's gonna take us straight to field 33. Like I said, we're gonna have course play worker on the cultivating job on our field, and we're gonna do some planting ourselves. I still don't know what am I gonna plant on field 8. But for now, like I said, let us start course play. Go with 3 headland passes should be more than enough. It's gonna leave some spots that are not gonna be cultivated, but that's fine. It doesn't matter, we're gonna fix that later on. We're gonna fix that ourselves. And it looks like it's on the right path. It's gonna follow and start with the first headland pass. That's good. Looks like the combine is stuck on traffic, so let us jump into the tractor and clear the way. Let's keep pushing the tractor and the trailer. Guessing that was not the right place to start the tractor, so maybe we just move it just a little bit further away. In fact, you know what, let's start unloading. It's full at 90%. Probably the trailer is gonna be full as well after we finished unloading the combine. Let's see. It looks like we're gonna be full. So that means we're gonna have to drive to the sell point that we need to take all the sugar beets. And it also looks like that we're gonna have a lot of trips to make. So let us find the sell point. Of course, it's the furthest away. So we're gonna cut through the bushes right here. I'm not going all the way around. That will take forever. So we're gonna cut through the bushes right here. Alright, now we're on the main road. And it's only gonna take a moment until we're gonna reach that sell point. We're driving at top speed, 53 kilometers per hour, which is not bad at all. We obviously can do better. But that's the top speed on this tractor. It's not that slow either, so we can't complain about that. But let me just unload this, head on over back to the field. So I'll see you guys in just a quick moment. Okay, we made it to the sell point, and I just want to see how much we carried over from the field. And what I've done is I sold our two. Yeah, this is not working out great. Unloading with this trailer, it's not working out great. We have transported 7% out of the field, so that's just gonna take a lot of times, a lot of trips. And just for that, I sold our two trailers. One was able to carry 31,000, the second one 39,200 liters. So I have sold both our trailers. I bought two new ones modified by Stevie. They're not realistic at all. So I know some of you will be mad at me for doing that, but I did bought two trailers. We got them pretty much at the same price that we sold our two for. And now we're gonna head on over back at the field. So let's see. Let's try a new path. We're gonna still cut through some bushes to make it to the field, but at least it's not gonna be as bad. So for now, we're just gonna drive at the field. I already unloaded the combine once using our JCB and one of the two trailers. We do have both trailers attached to our JCB. I hope that tractor can carry both, can pull both trailers, because I'm pretty sure it's gonna struggle a little bit. But we're not climbing any hills, any mountains, so hopefully it's gonna go okay. That's our tractor on our right, cultivating our field. It's doing a pretty decent job, and we are almost at field 59, the field that we have a contract on. So let's see, maybe this will be at the best place for us to cut through the bushes. That's the straws we left behind when we harvested, I believe we harvested oat from this field before. But for now, let's see, the harvester is at 78% full, so let's jump into our JCB. We bought these two trailers. They're small, but like I said, they're mods. They're not original base game trailers. They can hold up to 60,000 liters, so not very realistic for the size of the trailers, but we kind of need to have these two trailers just so we can keep up with the combine. This harvester is doing pretty good on harvesting. It's pretty fast. It cannot hold that much, and it's gonna get full pretty quickly. That means we would have been just doing hauling from the field to the sell point. That was pretty much the only thing we would have been able to do, and I just want to do something else. Like I was saying earlier, I want to start planting field 8. It should be okay for now. Let us park our JCB here as well. And we unloaded twice, and we are at 62,000 liters. So it will take a while until it's gonna finish that field. Let's see, now this tractor, this field, the tractor that I want. Let's see. I'm gonna start moving all this equipment into our new shed pretty soon. And since we have soybeans selected, let's just go with that. Let's check the prices real quick. Soybean is dropping, but it's still a good price. But canola is actually best for now, so why not go with canola instead of the soybeans? We're gonna have probably all these three fields that are close to the farm with canola. That'll be 8, 13, and 14. Let me just open the gate, try to squeeze my way into the field. And I'm starting to think that it might be a good idea for us to move away from this farm, find a new farm that we can start a new let's play on. I remove the gate, the one going into field 14, this gate that is right here. Save the game, came back into the game, and the gate is closed, and it's still back at the field. So it's probably a good time or good idea for us to move away. There's some things that I don't like. I'm still having fun on the map. I still like the map, but there's some things that I'm not too crazy about. One obviously is there's no multi-angle terrain, and that kind of sucks. The second one is I cannot modify the map the way I want to or I would like to. There's no way we can remove the bushes. There's no way to extend the fields, obviously, because even if we cut the trees down and extend the fields, form one huge field out of two or three fields, there's gonna be bushes in the middle of the field, in the middle of the new field that we would create. That's another thing that I'm not crazy about a map. But like I said, it's still a good map. I'm still having fun on. But it's probably the best time for us to just find a new map. So if there is a map that you want to see me play on, please let me know in the comment section. We do still have American Life Farming on our other series. Maybe we can start play on Mercer County. Maybe that would be a good lot of fun. Let's play. I don't know, like I said, if you would like that, or if you want a new series on a different map, one map that you like in particular, please let me know. We can start a new map. I really wish I had GPS. Maybe I should have installed GPS on these tractors that we own. Maybe even sell some of these tractors, buy some new ones with GPS on. It would help a lot with going straight, not missing bits of the fields. We're doing a pretty decent job ourselves, but obviously GPS would have been a lot of help. But for now, let's see where the combine is, the harvester, and unload that harvester. The amount of sugar beet that we're gonna get from this field, maybe I should have bought like 4 or 6 trailers. That would have been more helpful, obviously. But then we would have just wasted money that I don't wanna waste on just trailers. Obviously, we're looking to buy more fields. And it's not worth buying more trailers since we're not gonna make that much money off the contract. We're not being justified for us to buy new trailers. We are making this money obviously from this contract, but only if we are not gonna spend money on something that we don't really need. We do have these two trailers, and we do have the one that we borrowed for the job that will take us to over just a little bit over 90,000 liters. Alright, I'm kind of driving left and right, but doesn't matter. We almost completely unloaded the harvester, so let's not worry about that. Our friend is just about to finish this field, so let's stay around, let's stick around and be here when it's done, so we can fix these parts that he didn't go and cultivate. Then we're gonna take it over to field 18. We're gonna set him on a course play on that field so we can continue planting canola on our field 8. So let's stop him and go ahead and fix these parts of the field that he didn't fix, that he didn't cultivate. This is not gonna take that long. I'm gonna be done in a quick moment. But let me fix this off camera and I'll see you guys when we're at field 18. Alright, we are completely full with our JCB holding the two trailers. We just unloaded the combine. We did move our Fendt over to field 18. We set it on a course play worker to cultivate that field. After he's done, we still have 14 and 13. And obviously, we need to finish planting field 8, but keeping up with the harvester on the sugar beet field in field 59, it's gonna be a lot of fun. Obviously, we don't get to do much because we need to head on over and unload the combine. Our JCB is indeed struggling a little bit to pull these two trailers. Obviously, we have 120,000 liters, which is quite a lot. But we're not gonna run into any issues because obviously we're driving on flat terrain, we're not climbing, we're not driving uphill or something. So the only struggle I think I'm gonna have is trying to fit through the gates right here at the sell points with our JCB and the trailers. So let's see if I can squeeze through. I think I've managed to do that, and we are at the sell point. And what I think it would be best is just reverse into the sell point with just single trailer at a time. So let's see. This should take us to maybe 20-21% finished with the contract, finished hauling the sugar beet, not with the entire contract. For now, we are at 28% done with the contract. And let's see how much we managed to bring over from one trailer. 21%, that's good. That means that our second trailer should take us to probably 35%, or at least I think that's gonna be the case. Let's see if I can go back up with the inside view, in the cabin view. See how many times I'm gonna crash into the sell point. Nope. I had no idea I'm this good at going in reverse with a trailer. And we are at 35% transported for field 59. As I said, 60,000 liters would be like 14%. So that's good. Now let's attach the other trailer. And the harvester is already at 49%. That means it's kind of like gonna be full by the time we are gonna be back at the field. Let me just head back, unload, and I'll see you guys if I get a chance to go back into field 8 and continue planting. Otherwise, we're gonna be stuck in the middle of the field with crops growing around us. So I'm gonna try to unload the harvester as fast as I can and then resume planting on field 8. All right, we made it to the field. We unloaded the harvester into our trailer, the trailer that we bought, that we were pulling with the JCB. And hopefully now we're gonna have time until it's gonna be full again, until we're gonna need to unload the harvester again. Hopefully we're gonna have enough time to finish planting this field. Probably we will, because the combine, the harvester on field 59 started going up and down the field. That's gonna take longer than going on the headland passes. Obviously now it's gonna waste a lot of time going in reverse and heading over, trying to find its course play. But it doesn't matter. I was kind of expected that it will take a lot of time until we're gonna finish that field. So it doesn't matter. We're gonna wait until it's finished. We're gonna finish planting this field. And then obviously we're gonna probably move the planter over at field 33. We need to plant that field. First I'm gonna have to go check if we're gonna need to spray lime on that field. We probably need to. But anyway guys, this is gonna be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please consider subscribing to the channel. It will help us grow. And that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys on our next episode.